Hey everybody, hope you're doing well. Welcome back to a very interesting episode of CSK News. Thank you all for watching. As always, all today's news stories will be time marked down below in the description for you guys to bounce around to whatever stories you want to hear about. Let's hop into our first story though for today's episode of CSK News, and that is the ever-progressing Immortals situation. Now, I'm sure many of you guys are aware of the situation that started out a while ago. We now have Henny and Lucas on the bench, those two brothers alongside KNG. All three have been benched as of right now on the Immortals roster, and now we have other rumors out there saying that yes, it will be Bolts leaving to SK Gaming, replacing Phillips on that roster. And today, as of right now, HLTV has confirmed one step closer to that. It seems as of right now, pretty much confirmed here, 99% confirmed that SHG from the current Tempo Storm roster will join these guys on Team Immortals. He'll be replacing Bolts, who will then go to SK Gaming and replace Phelps on that roster. Now, I'm sure if you guys are not aware of this, this past weekend, a little bit of a spoiler happening right now. We had the Epicenter Finals. That was actually a $500,000 tournament, one of the bigger ones we have for the close of 2017. And that was SK Gaming's very first official tournament with Bolts on their roster in place of Phelps. And of course, if you guys know the results, they did very well. They actually won the whole event with him on that roster. He pretty much solidified his spot on the roster, and they themselves have actually confirmed it as well. He's pretty much an official member for SK Gaming and will be abandoning his former teammate, that is Steel. And it seems kind of sad. I pointed this out in the past as well. What do you guys think about this? It's almost sad to watch the deterioration, the depletion of this roster. It seems all the top tier players who were formerly on the Immortals roster have one either been benched. We have the three guys currently on the bench right now. One of the most powerful, if not the number one bench in the whole CSGO scene right now is the Immortals bench. Alongside that, we have everyone else who is not benched. They're just leaving them all together. We have Bolts now leaving Steel as well. Steel has been abandoned on this team, and it's now looking like what used to be a top 10 team in the world, Team Immortals, is now looking like a current day Tempo Storm. Tempo Storm currently has two rosters, a European and Brazilian roster. It seems now they've almost fully overwhelmed this new Immortals roster, and they have now become a new low tier Brazilian team roster, with people like ZQK being one of those players in Brazilian scene right now who gets the most flack of anyone based off his statistics. And again, we have a stand-in player, or a former stand-in, Horvey. Alongside that, now SHZ allegedly going to join these guys. The only real top-tier pro in that lineup now exists is actually Steel. What do you guys think about this? Kind of a sad story to see, but also on top of that, other roster changes out there and teams that have been struggling, that is actually Team Hellraisers. Many of you guys are aware the past 2 years have actually made major qualifiers time and time again. This year, they did fail to even make the minor, though, so they will not be our next E-League major in early 2018. They've actually failed because of a string of changes on their roster. Now, first off, we had quite a while ago them, of course, losing Styko to Mouse Sports. That was a big announcement. Not to mention, they just previously lost, actually very currently here a few weeks ago, they lost Bondic to Ty Lu for a two-month trial period. No one saw that coming, a CIS guy going to a Chinese team. On top of that, just last week, they also benched one of their players, Zero, and they've now brought in their newest member. They actually pulled in, that was Fej from Team Denial, and alongside that, they also pulled in a new member from Team Gux and Friends. And kind of funny because one of their current members, Woxic, is also formerly of that team, so there can be kind of some good chemistry there at least. That is actually ISAA, their newest member on the team, guys. And yes, now two of their current five members are actually from Gux and Friends. If you guys remember, Gux was actually a former Fnatic pro. He came back to the scene and started a pro team with these guys on it, and he's done quite well at placing these guys on other big teams. So Team Hellraisers, as of right now, is kind of struggling. Who knows what's going to happen in terms of what other tournaments they're going to be playing in. Like I said before, they actually failed to make this current major qualifier or even the minor itself. They actually went 1-3 at that minor qualifier itself, losing to teams like AGO, and alongside that, teams like Binary Dragons and Space Soldiers. Kind of some upsets there. I think Space Soldiers is one of those teams that plays very well online, but a team like that we've said previously, a team like Binary Dragons, you never would have put ahead of them in the past. So Hellraisers is definitely struggling. What do you guys think about that? But now on to another story out there. We had a huge Kenny S announcement coming sometime soon, actually announced on his Instagram about a week ago. I showed you guys this yesterday in our recap episode, and it has seemed his final announcement has come out, guys, and it's for a website known as Flick.gg. So we did actually say on the previous episode, it was probably going to be a sponsorship offer. Most likely, he was actually paid to do this, guys. It's actually a website called Flix.gg, which makes real-life avatars of pro players out there. Kind of some cool screenshots on screen for all of you guys. I'm not really understanding the full ability or capability of the website itself, or the full understanding of what the website has for goals, but it does seem in the future we're going to be seeing some other pro players actually align with this website itself and show some quick clips of them and actually some cool avatars made of those pro players. So I'm not really sure what the overall arching goals of this website is, but it seems like a very cool thing to do, and that was some cool Kenny S news for all of you guys. Now, on top of that as well, on this current Stannis Law story out there, it does seem as of right now we're not really sure if his Twitter has been hacked. If you guys did not stay tuned yesterday, we did have, apparently Stannis Law's Twitter handle was changed to "see ya," and his last tweet posted was a peace sign saying he might be, or hinting that he might be, either hacked or maybe leaving Team Liquid. Now, of course, Liquid is doing quite well in terms of other North American teams out there as of right now, and we've had no response at this point in time or any replies from his Twitter account if he is hacked or if it's just a troll by him or if he actually is leaving Liquid. We'll keep you guys posted on that in the next few days. Now, on top of that, our very last story today as well, we continue to talk about the Team Rogue struggles. And many of you guys are aware, the very well North American player on that roster, that is Hiko. He joined this Team Rogue several months ago, trying to revamp the roster itself. He has actually made more money not playing with this team than he actually has with it. He has made more money playing H1Z1 tournaments than for this Team Rogue roster, which you can't blame him at all for, but they have faced an immense amount of struggles so far. So to give you guys a quick background of that, initially when they actually started this roster, they had a 14-year-old Bulgarian player. It was going to be their opper known as Cirque. He was pulled away last second by money by Team NRG, and that actually never got him back. On top of that, they also had a new player to join that roster to fill his spot. That was Wardell from Ghost Gaming. He then eventually left back to Ghost Gaming. Kind of an ironic coincidence there, because the only team doing worse than Team Rogue right now is the team that Wardell went back to, Ghost Gaming. Currently, Rogue sits at 4-16, not doing too hot, but Ghost Gaming is actually 3-18, so they're doing a lot worse. And also on top of that, though, we actually expected both these teams to be towards the bottom, but even more problems actually struck the team, as apparently this week we actually had Decay post this as well. Shinobi, one of their current roster members, will be benched for an illicit reason. We're not really sure as of right now what that reason will be, in terms of course the team is probably struggling dealing with their record, and it will be former North American pro player and current streamer Whitmer to fill in for that roster. Now, kind of a funny story, because I had someone reach out to me a long time ago, an inside source told me that Whitmer was kind of upset because when this team was originally founded, the Team Rogue roster was actually offered out there. Whitmer's name was actually never brought up, so kind of convenient his name is now brought up, and apparently for the rest of ESL Pro League season, Whitmer will play for this team alongside streaming part-time. So I guess congrats to Team Rogue for picking up Katie, and alongside that, of course, we have their newest addition, Whitmer. The team is certainly struggling, but it's great to see that hopefully Whitmer has another chance here to prove himself in some lower tier ESL Pro League matches, and we'll see how they finish out the season. So as always, hope you guys all enjoy today's episode of CSK News. I have some very important things going on right now. I'm talking to someone very important right now in the scamming CSGO scene. I'm going to have a big episode about that sometime soon, this week or next week. So hope you guys all enjoyed. Please leave a comment down below what your favorite story was. As always, my name is Jake. Remember, I like you, and I'll see you all in a couple days. Remember, I like you. Goodbye.